Hallelujah, 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 praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord, hallelujah, praise ye the Lord, hallelujah, praise ye the Lord, hallelujah, praise ye the Lord.
Praise, what's that? It's a
tax collectors and sinners came to listen to Jesus teach. The religious leaders complained because Jesus welcomed sinners. So Jesus told them three parables to teach them about God. Jesus said, "If a man has 100 sheep and loses one, what does he do? He leaves the 99 sheep and searches for the lost sheep until he finds it. Then he tells his friends and neighbors, 'Let's celebrate, I found my lost sheep.' In heaven, there is more joy when one sinner repents and turns back to God than for 99 people who did not wander off." Jesus also said, "If a woman has 10 silver coins and loses one of them, what does she do? She lights a lamp, sweeps the house, and searches carefully until she finds it. Then she tells her friends and neighbors, 'Let's celebrate, I found my lost coin.'" Then Jesus repeated, "In heaven, there is joy when one sinner repents and turns back to God." Jesus told a third story. A man had two sons. The younger son said, "Father, give me my inheritance today." So the father gave his son his share. The younger son left home. He wasted his money and lived foolishly. There was a famine and the people in that country did not have enough food. The son got a job feeding pigs. He was so hungry, even the pigs' food looked tasty. The younger son made a plan. He would go back to his father and admit he was wrong. He would ask to work for his father like the servants. So the younger son headed home. He was still a long way away when his father saw him coming. His father ran to him, threw his arms around him, and kissed him. The son began to apologize. "I have sinned against God and against you," he said. But the father told his servants, "Let's celebrate with a feast. Bring the best robe and put it on my son. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. This son of mine was lost, and now he is found." At this time, the older son came from the fields and heard music at the house. "What's going on?" he asked one of the servants. "Your brother is here," the servant said. "Your father is celebrating." The older brother was angry. He refused to go to the feast. The father asked him to come inside. The older brother said, "I never disobeyed you, but you never threw a party for me." "Son," the father said, "everything I have is yours. We have to celebrate. Your brother was lost, but now he is found." Jesus told stories about people who were looking for things that were lost. Jesus told these stories to teach about himself. Jesus looks for people who are lost, people who do not know him. Jesus gave his life to save people from sin.
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for questions from kids. Adrian from Paris, Tennessee asks,
"A kid at school who is mean to others just started coming to my church. What should my friends and I do when we see him at church?"
Adrian, I think the first thing we need to recognize, it's great when anybody comes to church. It really is a sign that God is at work in their heart and they have a chance to hear the gospel and see other people like you who love Jesus and can experience what it means to have a relationship with him. So when I think about this kid at school being mean to others, I have to go two different directions. Either this kid is a believer who is not acting out the way he should, that he's not letting the gospel take root in his heart so that he's loving other people, and that's a problem. Or this kid is not a believer at all, and he needs Jesus Christ. He needs to hear the gospel, trust in Jesus, and let Jesus change him so that he loves other people. And either way, what's the best thing for him? The best thing is for him to be around kids like you who love Jesus and love him. And so when this kid comes to church, I think you want to really love this person well. Welcome him, show him forgiveness, show him love and grace and mercy so that he can see that God makes a difference in the hearts and lives of those who love Jesus. And so you're modeling this to him either way. Either he needs, as a believer, needs to repent of his sin, of being mean to others, and walk with Christ again rightly, or trust in Jesus for the first time. I think it's exciting that you and your friends have the chance to be Jesus in front of this kid so he can follow Jesus too. So here's a question back for you. How can the way you treat someone show that person the truth about Jesus?
Stories of the Bible, the prodigal son. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He healed many people from their sickness, performed many miracles like calming storms, and even raised people from the dead. Jesus taught everyone about God's love. All kinds of people would come to hear Jesus speak, including tax collectors and people who made bad choices. This made the Pharisees and Jewish leaders mad.
Ah, yuck.
They didn't think that Jesus should be around these kind of people. So Jesus told them this story. A man had two sons. The younger son told his father,
Excuse me?
I want my share of your estate now, before you die.
Okay.
So his father agreed and gave his son his inheritance.
Woohoo!
A few days later, this younger son packed all his belongings.
See ya!
And moved to a distant land. And there he wasted all his money in wild living.
Huh?
About the time his money ran out, a great famine swept over the land.
Aw, man!
And he began to starve.
Hey, you!
He convinced a local farmer to hire him.
Dinko!
And the man sent him into his fields to feed the pigs. The young man became so hungry that even the food he was feeding the pigs looked good to him. But no one gave him anything. Finally, he said to himself, "At home, even the servants have food enough to spare. And here I'm dying of hunger.
I know.
I will go home to my father and apologize and ask him to take me on as a servant." So he returned home to his father. And while he was still a long way off, his father saw him coming. Filled with love and compassion, he ran to his son.
Son!
His son said to him, "Father, I have sinned against both heaven and you, and I am no longer worthy of being called your son." But his father said to the servants, "Quick, bring the finest robe in the house and put it on him. Get a ring for his finger and sandals for his feet. And kill the calf we have been fattening. We must celebrate with a feast, for this son of mine was dead and now has returned to life. He was lost, but now he is found." So the party began.
Alright, yeah!
Meanwhile, the older son was in the fields working. When he returned home, he heard music and dancing in the house.
Huh? Hey, you!
And he asked one of the servants what was going on. Your brother is back, he was told, and your father has killed the fattened calf. We are celebrating because of his safe return.
Woohoo! All right, party time! All right, yahoo!
The older brother was angry and wouldn't go in. His father came out and begged him.
Oh, man!
But he replied, all these years I've slaved for you and never once refused to do a single thing you told me to. And in all that time, you never gave me even one young goat for a feast with my friends. Yet when this son of yours comes back after wasting your money, you celebrate by giving him a great feast. His father said to him, look, dear son, you have always stayed by me, and everything I have is yours. We had to celebrate this happy day, for your brother was dead and has come back to life. He was lost, but now he is found.